What a colorful look on this channel. I never would have guessed it. I feel like $1 million right now. Things can get a little hairy. Hello! Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being here. That was super sweet of you. Oh my goodness, we have such an exciting video for you today. I know I say that every video, but it really is an exciting video today. And yes, I know, elephant in the room, I am wearing the same iconic pink sweater that I wore like 3 videos ago because it's my favorite sweater and it's super comfy and it's oversized, but that's not what this video is about. You did not click on this video to listen to me over explain why I only wear this sweater. It's because it's so comfortable. Look at it. It's oversized. It's like, you can't even see how long it is on camera. That's how long it is. It's so comfy. Oh, I love it so much. It's from American Eagle. My boyfriend's mom got it for me for Christmas. That was super sweet of her. No, you clicked on this video because you, like me, have an interest in how to incorporate graphic liner into your eyeshadow looks or something of that nature. I haven't decided the title yet. If you're not new to my channel, then you already know how I feel about graphic liner. I love graphic liner. Graphic liner is my family. Graphic liner is my mom. Graphic liner is my dad. It's my sister, my brother, my pet. I'm just kidding. I have real people for all of those. But I love graphic liner so much. And lately, I've been very into incorporating graphic liner into my eyeshadow looks. Because when I first started out doing graphic liner, I would just do it over like a translucent shimmery shadow, you know, just to add a little bit of something underneath. But lately I've been very into like doing a full eyeshadow look and then incorporating the graphic liner into that look. And I know I get a lot of comments on my Instagram photos and on my videos. Ugh, brag, I'm sorry. I get a lot of comments of people saying that they really like my graphic liner and that they wanna try it, but they're nervous to start. So I wanna make some more graphic liner videos for you guys. Some tutorials, if you will. I know I'm not really a tutorial channel, but I do feel like I'm pretty good at explaining graphic liner. So I'm gonna be doing that for you here today and showing you how to put it into your eyeshadow looks. So if that sounds like a topic that is interesting to you and you wanna see me do that, then I encourage you to please subscribe and keep on watching. It's coming at you right now. Okay, so I think for today's eyeshadow look, I'm gonna go in with the Midas Cosmetics Flower Bomb Palette. I love this palette. I got a whole review on it if you wanna check that out. But I like it because it's got a bunch of different beautiful colors in it and it's gonna be a colorful look. I know you're shocked, you're surprised. You're like, what, a colorful look on this channel? I never would have guessed it. But yeah, I like colorful makeup. Ooh, look, you're all zoomed in. Look at that highlight. This is awesome from Midas Cosmetics. It's from their collab with Neon MUA, the Dawn Face Palette. I love it so much. It's so pretty. But yeah, okay, so for this look, you're gonna need an eyeshadow and you're gonna need some graphic liners. Well, not graphic liners, water activated liners, or just any colorful liner that you have. I do have some other videos on water activated liner and graphic liner if you wanna check those out, where I really talk about like what my favorites are, what my favorite brushes are and all that. But today is gonna be more focused on actually showing you how to do it. And you know, I'm gonna be giving you tips and tricks along the way because that's my whole thing. Giovanna tips and tricks of the future. It's my Disney Channel original series, Giovanna of the Future, colon tips and tricks. Great. So for our first step for this graphic liner eyeshadow look, what I like to do is put a color in my crease and I like to stamp it in there almost like it is a liner, if that makes sense. So there's a very particular shape I like to go for when I know I'm gonna be doing graphic liner. And what I like to do is put my colors in the crease and then colors on the lid, and I don't worry too hard about connecting those. So the type of look I'm gonna be doing doesn't involve a lot of blending. And honestly, I think that's why it's a look I thrive with, because blending, it's not my strong suit. So what color should we go for today? Ooh, something you should have thought about first, perhaps. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with this beautiful pink shade. It's called Daisy, and I'm just gonna stamp my brush in here. And the type of brush I'm using, this is actually from my Cheeky Beauty brush set. I did a whole video on Cheeky Beauty Box. This is just like a little C-shaped brush. Anything you can do a stamping motion with would probably work great. So now what I'm gonna do is just put that in my creasy crease area. Like I said, this look doesn't involve a lot of blending. So if you're not good at blending, well, welcome to the club, because I'm not good at blending either, but I am good at it's stamping. Stamping is a strong suit for me. Now, actual stamps, I got a lot of questions about. I usually have to call my mom if I'm looking for the right stamps, because I never remember what kind of stamps are supposed to go where. You'd think forever stamps can go everywhere, right? But they can't. They don't go everywhere. I think. Do they? I don't know. That's enough about stamps, I think. I'm gonna get back to stamping my eyeshadow. But okay, so then I also like to take it a little further outside the crease here. And if you have hooded eyes, baby, it's all good. So do I. This look can work for anyone. Just go like this and make sure you're going above where your crease is, you know, where that, like, you can see where my eyelid and my crease kind of fold here. Just go right over your fold and it's all good. And if you don't have hooded eyes, well, then of course you could do this because you don't have hooded eyes and everything's easy for you, right? I'm just kidding. I'm sure you have your own struggles. Okay, now what I like to do is just bring that in a little bit. I'm basically doing like my graphic liner shape, but with eyeshadow. But I don't have to worry about being as precise because I am gonna fill in the middle here. But you know, just bring it in, create a very graphic shape, but with eyeshadow, you know? So definitely I would recommend using some pretty pigmented shadows. These Midas Cosmetics shadows are very pigmented because you're gonna be doing a stamping motion. You're not like blending it out or anything. So I would recommend using pigmented shadows just because I think they look better. They look nice and bold along with your bold graphic liner. So that's the way I like to do it. So now I'm just taking the shadow down a little bit further with that first color because I only want my shimmery shades to go from like here to here, but it's all personal preference. If you don't wanna bring that shadow in, then you don't have to and you can put the shimmer totally all over the lid. But that's just what I like to do. It's a choose your own adventure tutorial. I don't know why I'm talking like John Lennon, but I am, and that's okay. Is that a good Lennon impression? I don't know. I wasn't around when he was around. Let's move on to the next step. It's a goofy tutorial. Okay, those of you who have watched a tutorial of mine before already know what time it is, but if you're new, it is 9:52 a.m., but also time for some glitter primer. Now, I'm not gonna be using a glitter today, but I am gonna be using some shimmery shadows. And like I've said a million times on this channel, ever since I saw Beaut Bean use NYX Glitter Primer with all of her shimmery shadows and how beautiful they looked, I just do the same thing. And so I'm kind of cutting a crease here. I'm going a little bit over the matte shadow just because I want the shimmery to go a little bit higher. The shimmery, we don't need to say shadow, just calling them shimmeries now. Put the glitter primer wherever you want your shadow to go. That is my hot tip from me to you, a hot tip that is original to me, but a hot tip that I do feel like is a little more original to me is that I like to let the glue dry for a minute. I know it's controversial to say, but I do like to let the glue dry for a minute, just kind of like lash glue, you know, when you let it get tacky, I feel like everything sticks better. And if you try to go in with your shimmers like immediately after putting down the glitter glue, things can get a little hairy. Well, not hairy, but sticky. So I like to wait a second. Okay, now what I'm gonna be doing is going in with this beautiful multi-chrome that I got from Dawn Eyes Cosmetics. I got a whole video trying these multi-chromes if you wanna check it out. If you haven't noticed by now, I make videos to justify my purchasing. So if I ever talk about something, yeah, there's probably a video on it. But so I'm just gonna be taking kind of a fluffy brush like this and dipping it into the multi-chrome. It's a loose pigment multi-chrome situation we got going on here. How pretty. You're gonna scream when you see it. And you could totally just go in with a shimmery pink shadow, but I have this multi-chrome, so like, why wouldn't I go in with it, you know? It's pink, it's beautiful, it's lovely, I love it. Okay, and I'm just gonna stick that to this glitter glue. Oh, and a little bit of it is getting on my face, but what are you gonna do? You can't do anything now. Wow, dude, look at that, it's so pretty. I have to get more of these Dawn Eyes multi-chromes. They are so pretty. I got like the trial size when I placed my order, which was dumb because I should have known that I was gonna want more of them. But honestly, Dawn Eyes has a really good thing you can do where you can buy like a super tiny size of their multi-chromes and it's only like $6. So definitely check them out. I know this is not what this video is about, but that's not what this video is about. But I had to mention it. So we're gonna give my face a spritz so that stays in place. Probably a little too close. That was definitely too close. Okay, so let that dry for a second, and don't you worry, we're getting to the graphic liner. It's coming at you right now. Okay, as promised, it's time for some graphic liner. So I'm gonna be using water activated liners today. If this is your first ever graphic liner of mine, you're watching, hi, hello, welcome. I'm freaking thrilled you're here. But water activated liners are a cake sort of a liner that basically what you do is you wet your little brushy brush and then you swirl them around and it makes a liquid liner for you. But it's better than regular liquid liner because it's water activated and it's super smooth and it doesn't get gross and crumbly and cakey and it's a good time. So I'm using this one from Be Elegant Cosmetics, which is an awesome indie brand that makes beautiful pastel liners. Of course I got a video for them too. What am I gonna buy something and not make a video about it? But yeah, so I am also taking this by Melolops X-Cut Creaser brush. By Melolops is another wonderful graphic liner brand, and Cut Creaser is a person they did a collab with who is a wonderful graphic liner artist. So these brushes rock. Honestly, one of the best purchases of 2020 I made. But so I'm dipping my brush in the water and then I am swirling it around to make my liquid liner. It's a very interesting science experiment. Bill Nye could never. He probably could. He probably loves water activated liner. Oh my god, petition to get Bill Nye to wear graphic liner, am I right guys? But so now what I'm gonna do to connect this eyeshadow look and liner look together is zoom in a little more because you're gonna wanna pay attention to this. Okay, so now you see where our shimmery shadow meets the matte shadow. We're gonna start our line right there and basically just go over it and flick it out. Like we're following the shape of the eyeshadow and our starting point is where the shimmery shadow meets the matte shadow. And this type of brush works great for that. It's kind of like a longer tip and it's really smooth and flexible. So here's what I'm doing. Kind of how people cut a crease with what do you use to cut a crease? Concealer? But I'm doing it with eyeliner. I like to start with only a little bit of water activated liner. Like I obviously like to get the brush pretty wet, but not too wet, because if you get the brush too wet, then you can end up with drips, and drips are a nightmare. I will be honest with you guys. If you end up with too much water on your brush and it starts dripping down, it's tough to fix. So I would rather go in with a little product and just add more. Doesn't that just make you feel like $1 million? I feel like $1 million right now. I dare I say $1,005,000 because I feel very glamorous. I feel like that just totally changed the game of the look here. And you could stop here. This could be your look. Throw some mascara on, head out the door. Put your mask on first, but head out the door. But for me, I am gonna connect it to the bottom here because I like to make it look like my eyeshadow's in a little box. And yeah. So I'm dipping back into my pastel pink liner. You could also use white eyeliner. If you were looking to just get like one color eyeliner to start with, get white, because you can put it over eyeshadow and it looks so beautiful. And especially if you have a deeper skin tone, white eyeliner looks phenomenal. It looks so, so beautiful. I love white eyeliner, but I am using these pastels right now. And honestly, check out my other water activated liner reviews because I review a lot of water activated liners that come in like sets and are a super reasonable price point. Like these pastels came in a set of 7 and they were only like $30, which is a pretty good deal. And By Melolops has like a set of 8. I think for $40, or you could just buy one in a bigger size, you know? So this, I got a lot of graphic liner content. I'll link it all down below. But yeah, back to my tutorial. So what I'm gonna do now is start right at the lash line here, and I'm just gonna connect it. This is my favorite brush from the Cut Creaser X by Melolops set. It's their C2 brush. I think you can get this brush on its own for like $10, which honestly I think is worth it. I know the set of 4 is $32 and I like all of those brushes, but any sort of a brush like this with a thin flexible tip, the thing about graphic liner brushes is you gotta have a thin tip. That's the best thing for it. Cause even if you think like, oh, I don't want my lines to be that thin, they're not gonna be as thin as the brushes. Once you put product on the brush, it gets bigger. That's probably something you already knew because you are logical, but I'm not always logical. So I need to really nail it home that this is a good brush, and I'll link a bunch of brushes down below. Okay, so like I mentioned earlier, this is a choose your own adventure tutorial. You could stop here, but I'm gonna do one more thing. So this is a By Melolops X-Cut Creaser Water Ink, and I am using the C1 brush from the Cut Creaser X By Melolops set. Can you see it? Can you see it? Can you see it? I'll put it in front of my eye so you can see it. It's a really, really tiny brush. Tiny tips. Tiny tips is my tip to you. And what I'm gonna do is extend my inner corner here. I'm not trying to like elongate my eye or anything. I'm just trying to basically outline my inner corner and make it look kind of brighter. And I think it offsets this part of the eyeliner nicely when I extend the inner corner. So what I'll do is I start right here. I just go like that And when this step, you really want to be careful not to get too much product on your brush, because that's, you don't want to get it in your eye. That could be a little bit painful, although it's just like water and pigments, but it's still as painful to get in your eye. And then I'm going to bring it back up here. You can bring it in as far as you want. I like to bring it like right to where my pupil starts. There's that technical term for you. And then I'm gonna extend that top one just a little bit, essentially just to match what it looks like on the bottom. Like I'm gonna bring the top line in the same amount as I did the bottom line, right to my pupil. And with this part, I really like to keep my eye open as I'm doing the line, because if you do it with your eye closed, then you're gonna get like a disconnect from the top or the bottom. So I really like to go in here like this and just make sure everything is super, super connected. Okay, so I'm gonna resist the temptation to add like 40 more graphic lines, because I love graphic liner so much and I could just overdo it all day. But instead, I will do the other eye and then come back and then do a little wrap up for you, show you my final look. All right, and we're back. I have a nose ring in now. Yep, that's right. It's been so long that I went out and got my nose pierced and came back. I'm kidding, it's a fake nose ring, but as I always like to over explain, I had my nose pierced at one point. Ready? There's a freaking nose hole in my nose here. You definitely can't see it, but it closed up because it got infected. So now I just put fake nose rings in my nose hole scar. All pertinent information. Look at this look. I feel like it came out so good. I'll give you one final zoom in to show you the graphic liner and eyeshadow look. I had so much fun doing this. I feel like this is a pretty easy look to do. I know, I feel like sometimes I say things are easy and everyone's like, meh, is that really easy though? But with graphic liner, it just takes practice, you know. I have some more basic graphic liner videos on my channel that I'll link down below that I show you some really basic shapes, although this is a really basic shape, and I also feel like this is a good way to delve into graphic liner. If you're somebody who's already very comfortable with eyeshadow, then just do your normal eyeshadow look and then like put a line over it, you know? That's really all I did. And I feel like this is a pretty simple look to do. If you recreate this look, please tag me on Instagram so I can scream and hype you up. Even if you don't feel like you did a good job, tag me and I will hype you up, and I won't even be lying because I bet you're gonna do a great job. But my Instagram handle is @glamgonyc. If you're not following me on Instagram, what the heck, follow me on Instagram. I post there way too dang much. I post like 40 pictures of Bird a day. I'm sure it's really annoying, but I think it's really fun. So definitely follow me on Instagram. And if you've made it to the end of the video and you're not subscribed, what the heck are you doing? I don't understand why you would watch till the end of the video and not subscribe. That seems silly. Subscribing is free, it's fun, it's fresh, it's certified fresh on Rotten Tomatoes. It has a 100% score. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and sometimes Saturdays. Also, please check out my description box for everything on my face today, all of those brushes I mentioned, and all corresponding videos I will link down below. Also in my description box is a bunch of Black Lives Matter resources. I have petitions to sign, places to donate, and ways to help protesters. So please click on those links if you have the time. I thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!